Hi, this is George Lorenz again, and today I would like to explain the reasoning of my presentation method that I use in my math videos. I mean, I'm really convinced that this is the best way of introducing any new concept in mathematics, and that's why I'm sticking to it even after almost 2 years that I have my channel. I have only 57 subscribers, but I really am convinced that this is the best method of presenting topics in math. There are three steps in each topic that I present. So the first one is the when a student has to use this topic. I mean, sometimes this is obvious. Let's say the problem ask you to find the roots of a system using a substitution method. So in this case, it's obvious. But in most of the cases, and specifically if you have big exams at the end of the semester or the end of the year, where you have so many problems, and you know, which go back to the whole, to the topics that you cover the whole year. So in this case, the most important question that I get all the time from students, and I believe you realize that too, is what I have to use. So that's why in all my presentations I always explain on this when I explain when you have to use it. So if you have, let's say for example, you have an implicit function, so then you have to use implicit differentiation. So when you know where you have to use each topic, then it's easy in your final exam specifically or in a big exam to know what to use to solve the problem. The second step is always to state the brief theory. I mean, the reason behind this is that I mean, most of the videos that are posted in YouTube, they go directly to examples. Me, I find I don't agree with this, because then when you try from the one example to solve the other, you have to make assumptions and conclusions about how to proceed from one example to the other. So, and sometimes these assumptions are not correct, while when you have the theory, you know clearly how to proceed, the steps that you have to take to solve the problem. And finally, I mean, this is the last step, which is an example, an illustrated example on the topic. I mean, this is something that everybody is doing, and I agree that it has to be part of the presentation. But in my opinion, there is no way that the example will substitute the theory of the topic. So in the illustrated example, one follows the steps that they are stated in the theory in order to solve the example. So thank you for taking the time to view this video. Your feedback is greatly appreciated, so you can help me to make my videos better for other students. And if you find this video useful, and in general my videos useful, of course I invite you to subscribe, so this way you will be notified immediately when I upload a new video in YouTube. Bye for now.
Have a great day.